Hello everyone, my name is Gairy and I'm with Oil Fuel Basics. Today I'm going to discuss all the incredible products that come as a result of the oil and gas industry. Many of us don't realize that almost every product that we use, whether it be at home, school, or work, somehow correlates to the oil and gas industry. So hopefully after this video, you understand what an impact this industry makes to our everyday lives.
The oil and gas industry is usually divided into three major sectors: upstream, midstream, and downstream. Oilfield Basics has supplemental content that touches base on these sectors. However, this video is mainly focused on the products we owe to oil and gas. The downstream sector is essentially the final step of the oil and gas process. Once the crude oil makes it to the downstream refineries, the petroleum crude oil is processed and purified into various useful products. A lot of times when people think of oil and gas, they think of transportation, whether it be the gasoline that goes into your cars, diesel for semi-trucks, or jet fuel for transportation. Well, in reality, there are so many more products that come from the oil and gas world. The very first separation process in refining is distillation. A distillation column is used to separate the crude oil into individual hydrocarbon components. A distillation column works on the different boiling points of each hydrocarbon. The lighter components will rise to the top and are known as the light products. As the column goes down, it rises in temperature and also in boiling points. So we have the medium products and then the heavier products. The lighter products are some of the things we are most used to seeing, such as gasoline for our car. There is also liquid petroleum gas and a solvent called naphtha that is usually used within the refining process for cracking, can be used in laundry soaps and cleaning fluids. Now, once we get to the medium products, this is the diesel fuel, kerosene, and jet-related fuels. Lastly, we have the heavier products. Some heavy products consist of lubricant oils, paraffin wax, asphalt tar, and petroleum coke. Other than the lighter products, usually distillation is not enough to separate medium and heavy products into useful components. Because of this, further processing has to happen through a series of complex chemical engineering conversions. Conversion units such as crackers, reformers, impurity removals, and blending are all involved with further processing of the heavier components to be used for useful products that we use each and every day. Now, I've named a couple, but at a glance, you can see that these are some more products that we receive from the oil and gas industry. Gasoline, jet fuel, things that we weren't aware of, such as lubricants, plastics, pesticides, fertilizers, nylons, and so much more. This image just helps you get a visual glance of all the things around us that we see that are a derivative of petroleum. One crazy example is makeup. A lot of cosmetic products, such as lipsticks and lotion, are made with petroleum derivatives. For example, paraffin wax, one of the heavier products, is used in lipsticks in order to keep their shape and go on smooth. You can see other products such as toys, tires, cones, household items, office items. Petroleum derivatives are in almost everything that we use. As you can see, many useful products come from the original crude oil. However, a lot of things within the processing has to be removed, such as impurities. But in refineries, they don't like things going to waste. For example, sulfur. And desulfurization is a critical role in the refining process. Removing sulfur is helpful to meet air quality requirements and to help clean burning fuels. Removing sulfur also helps set the price for many refineries. But after sulfur is removed, it is also converted into useful products such as sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is a key substance in the chemical industry. It's mostly used in the fertilizing manufacturing, but it's also important for mineral processing, oil refining, wastewater processing, and chemical synthesis. Sulfuric acid is used in the manufacturing of chemicals such as hydrochloric acid and nitric acid that is later used for many other common household items and office items that we use every day. The petrochemicals products flowchart is a visual representation of how oil and gas impacts us, each and every one of us. Petrochemical products are manufactured from raw materials onto feedstocks, basic chemicals, chemical intermediates and derivatives, and ultimately the final products that we see, such as furniture, building materials, consumer products, office and industrial equipment, and so much more. It's also important to realize how the oil and gas industry is making an impact on the pandemic that we are facing today. Something called plexiglass is becoming more and more prevalent in stores and work sites for our frontline health workers as a way to protect against the spread of COVID-19. Plexiglass is manufactured because it is lightweight, shattered resistant, and an alternative to glass. Plexiglass is a petroleum-based thermoplastic product, also known as an acrylic. This important product all comes from the origins of crude petroleum. So as you can see, the oil and gas industry is vital to our way of life. It impacts the way we live, the way we work, and almost everything around us. So the next time you're looking at your makeup brush, kitchen appliances, or office space, just think there's a really good chance that that product is a result of the oil and gas industry.